Ayubowan. Excitement to know what and why lead us into new knowledge. So let's learn about stage lighting fixtures. Thank you for watching my channel. Watch till the end and please comment. To give you more good contents and good videos, your comments, your questions and your ideas values a lot. It helps me a lot. So now let's get started. First we'll learn about bit of history. We'll talk about bit of history. In ancient storytelling, we can see lighting doing its part, setting the mood. In old days when storytelling, people have used campfire to light up the moment and give a vibe. We still love campfire, right? Then theaters came into play. Theaters were open air, facing from east to west, because when in the evening, with the natural light, they can light up the stage. By the time theaters started to use the dipped candle to light up the chandeliers and sconces to generate ambient lighting. In around 1780s, theaters replaced candles with oil lamp. And in 1860s, gas lights came into the theaters. By 1879, everything began to change with the invention of Edison's, the light bulb. With the invention of light bulb and other technologies, people started to use analog consoles. They built analog systems to control light, dim light. Later on, with the invention of computer, people started to use more advanced systems to control lighting, like AMX, CMX protocols. And later on, we came to DMX, what we use now. We have another video series of DMX. Learning a bit of history is not bad. So now let's come to the topic. Most used lighting fixtures in stage, theater, concerts and events. We have in-depth videos about each fixtures. For now, we'll talk about basics. There are many types of lighting fixtures. For today, we'll talk about basic lighting we almost use in every event. Number one, par light, or as most people say, par can. Parabolic aluminized reflector. Par light is a very lightweight, easy to use, a simple can-like fixture, mostly used as a wash fixture. Par can cover a large part of the stage where the spotlights can't cover or fill the gaps. Lamps with different diameters are used in par lights, par 64, par 36 and par 16. To use par lights, we need a dimmer pad to give the power and to control the intensity through that dimmer pad. We can cover the front with colored gels to obtain the colors we desire. Number two, Fresnel. Yes, it's pronounced Fresnel. Even I pronounced it wrongly at first, so learn from my mistakes. Same as par light, Fresnel is used to wash over an area of the stage. The beam is wide and soft in this. Fresnel is used mostly to backlight, top light and side lights. Nowadays, most Fresnels have zoom function and also it has barn doors to reduce the light going to unwanted areas or to audience eyes. Number three, ellipsoidal. Ellipsoidal reflector spotlight, or simply profile. An ellipsoidal reflector located at the back of the fixture gathers the light and reflects to front through shutters, lenses and colored gels. Profile is very useful to spot someone, highlight someone or an area. Also, profiles can use with gobos, a pattern cut into a plate, and when we place it in front of the light, we can project the pattern into a surface or a spotted area. With the change of the barrel and lens tube and adjusting it, we can change the sharpness of the beam. And also there are some lights with zoom function, so we can maximize or reduce the spot size. Number four, follow spot. Follow spot is a fixture that moved by an operator or by DMX during the performance. nowadays there are more advanced and automated systems for follow spot. This provides emphasis or extra illumination to a performer that moving around the stage and to highlight that person. Follow spots are commonly used in musicals, opera, theater, and concerts to highlight the main performer. Number 5, LED Parlight. LED Parlight is same looking as the traditional parlight, but without the bulb, it has replaced with light emitting diodes. LED parlights are useful to watch the stage or give a dramatic look with colors. With LED lights, it has made more easy to be creative and cost effective because we don't need to use color gels or dimmer packs to wash the areas or anything. With LED lights, we can get more colors and more effects. Number 6, Batten lights. Old days, it was called cyc light, mostly used to illuminate the cyclorama in theaters. Cyclorama is the curtain at the back of the stage. Early cyc lights are a long housing containing light bulbs and colored gels. Nowadays, we have replaced cyc lights with batten lights. We use batten lights to light up the cyclorama, wash walls, and to wash areas, and also especially as stage effects, we use batten lights mostly. Now, the final fixture, number 7, intelligent lights. Intelligent light or moving light are the most used lighting fixture nowadays. Principal feature is the ability to remotely control the movement and characteristic of the output beam. These light fixtures come in variety of different features and designs like spot, wash, beam, and hybrid. And nowadays, there are lots of intelligent lights in different brands with new options and new features. Mainly, we can control in intelligent lights the movement of the light, like pan and tilt, and the intensity of light with dimming or with shutters, and also colors by color wheels or color mixing. And of course, there's gobo, like adding some different designs to the beam. And also zoom and focus, and there are many more options in nowadays intelligent lights. As you know, intelligent lights are now used in almost in every event, concert, mainly in shows from small areas to larger arenas. We'll learn about intelligent light with another video. There are many types of lighting fixtures nowadays. These are just few of them. Please don't hesitate to comment your ideas, your questions about these fixtures or any other fixture, and also your ideas. It values a lot. Especially if there's anything you need me to share in my future videos, I'll be more than happy to learn and share that knowledge with you. Check my channel for more videos about basics of lighting, interviews, product demonstrations, and much more. Please don't forget to subscribe and keep in touch. Finally, keep making the magic happen with lighting. Till we meet with new knowledge to share, keep in touch and keep learning every day. God bless you.